An origami crane is one of the oldest origami documented. The first book on origami was Hiden Senbazaru Urikata, which was the secret of 1,000 origami cranes, which gave a method of how to fold the crane. So today we'll see how we fold an origami crane. We start with a square sheet of paper, and what we'll do is we'll firstly fold it along the diagonals, that is these lines. So how we do that is that we'll take one of these corners and we'll just put it on the other corner, the one which is diagonally opposite. Similarly, on the other diagonal. So we can see that there is this cross which has come up over here. Now turn this page over. Now what we'll do is we'll fold this in half. What we want is we want creases like this in a plus sign. Note that I have made these diagonals in one direction and the cross in the other. So right now, if you look at this, you can see a cross and a plus. So using this, what I'll do is I'll push my two fingers here and another two here, and I'll try to push from the bottom and bring this together. So this becomes again into a square. You can see that this square has got an opening and there's this part, the vertex. So what we have to do is we have to take all these edges, the ones which open up, and push them towards this half line. You all can see a crease with this half line. So we'll push this edge on this half line. And we have to do this for all the four edges. Mind you, this is a pre-crease. That is, we'll be opening this up again. So this pre-crease would help us in folding our crane. So on the other two sides. So since this is a pre-crease, we would actually try to do this in the other direction as well, just to help us fold. Okay, similarly on this direction, we'll open this and then we turn and push this back. So what to do next is that we take this part, and here we have got this crease, right? So we fold this back in half like this, from this point till this point. You can see these two points over here. So using this as a ratio over there, we just push this back, and now because of our creases, this just exactly folds itself in. Turn it over, the same thing. So this that we have gotten right now is called the bird base. Now, bird base can give us many things, crane, flappy bird. So today we are making a crane. So for making a crane, now you can see that this is the part which is pushed up, and you can see this triangle on the top. So this part which is pushed up, that is the top part. These two are the wings. This is the head, this is the tail, but we want to make them more pointed. So how do we do that? We take this edge and we again push it on the half line like this. Okay. We do this for all the four edges. Turn it around. Now, this is the whole body of a crane, but we don't want our heads and tails to be in the back, right? So we just open this part. So if you see, we can open it like this and just push this on the top like that. Similarly, this one. Either of them can be a head or a tail. but they are too much inside. So what we'll do is we'll push them a bit outside. This is a judgment fold. That is, it depends on you. How much you want the tail to be outside is completely a choice which you have to make. But right now, both of them look like a tail. So how do we make a head? We take one of these and we pinch it on the inside like this. And there you go. You have a crane. So what I like to do is I actually like to see it when these wings are coming outside. So for that, we'll have to flatten this top part, this top triangle. So we'll just push this, pull this apart a bit and flatten it from the top. And there you go. You have your crane.